In 2018, the Nonprofit Finance Fund conducted a survey to gain a pulse on the state of the sector. And what they found was that over the last 10 years, 86% of the 3,000 nonprofits surveyed had seen a continued increase in demand for their services, a demand that they were unable to keep up with. The reason for this is that nonprofits have been struggling with larger competition for grants and donations and decreasing fundraising potential. On top of that, financial uncertainty from economic events such as the Great Recession of 2008 have amplified these concerns. In fact, 48% of the nonprofits cut jobs in 2011 as a response to the economic fallout of the Great Recession. For all of these nonprofit organizations, uncertainty raises the serious question of survival and sustainability. And in the last several decades, an increasing number of nonprofits have looked to the social enterprise model as a potential solution. While many definitions exist, a social enterprise is generally defined as a nonprofit that utilizes for-profit revenue generation strategies to fund their social missions. Unfortunately, the social enterprise model is a relatively new topic of research, and much of the leading literature revolves around the ethical concerns of the model and how it is defined. Because of this, I felt the dialogue needed to transition from the philosophy surrounding social enterprise to an understanding of how exactly it can be implemented effectively. The question I used to guide me in this exploration was, how does the social enterprise model change funding strategies? In order to answer this question, I utilized a data collection process that was two-pronged, a content analysis and four semi-structured interviews, involving individuals from executive leadership teams of well-established social enterprises within the Seattle area. What I found was that there exists a general bias associated with the term social enterprise that has been found to affect both the perception and participation of donors. The newness and innovative perception of the terminology has created a favorable tailwind for the use of the model. All four interviewee subjects found that there was a general psychological bias favoring the rhetoric of social entrepreneurship, independent of the practices. Interview subject one, a past CFO of Fairstart, stated that the favorable perception of the model made their organization the darling of many grantmakers' portfolios. Along with the trending nature of the term, I found that there's a real favorability regarding the self-sufficiency of the model. All subjects who participated in the interview process said that many of the donors appreciated their organization's ability to self-sustain some of its own expenses. Subject 1 and 2 emphasized this point by stating that donors appreciated the lift yourself up by the bootstraps mentality. That said, many donors who appreciated the self-sufficiency of the approach were also found to not be aware of the other programs a part of the organization. Interview subject 2, who was a part of four separate social enterprises, stated that donors either know about your social enterprise initiative or they know about the other programs/services you provide. There's a disconnect that's difficult to bridge. Subjects 1, 3, and 5 mirrored the sentiment and agreed that the way your organization attracts the donors relies heavily on the organization's ability to be an effective relationship manager. One of the limitations to this research is that the definition of the social enterprise is still too broad in academic literature. The term is often applied to both for-profit and nonprofit organizations, and even within the context of the nonprofit sector, there are many variations. Therefore, I believe further research would benefit from an effort to better delineate/name and analyze the different types. Additionally, I believe that my sampling size was too small and localized to garner an effective picture of what social enterprises are doing to adopt their fundraising strategies nationally. So I believe there are two actions current social enterprises can make to have a bigger and more measurable effect in their fundraising efforts. First, the research suggests that they should embrace and understand the effects of the terminology, meaning flaunt it. Use the terminology in your messaging strategy. As both studies and interviews indicate that a new donor's perception can be positively influenced by the trending nature of the term. Conversely, the bias surrounding the concept serves as a warning for researchers to not let the study of social enterprise become a study of success. Secondly, my research suggests that many nonprofits would benefit from taking a stakeholder approach. Social enterprises operate in different sectors. They have a wide range of stakeholders with different information needs. By selecting the metric that best satisfies information needs of the specific stakeholder, you could then push the organization to be more intentional in their reporting efforts. Being able to properly measure your results would also emphasize the need to be able to differentiate the impact of the business from the results of the nonprofit programs, therefore highlighting the need to properly separate finances. I would like to finish by thanking you for listening today. My name is TC Payne.